Previously on Mile High.
Sorry, I'm late. I'm new.
You can give me a hand.
I feel the intent to make up to him later.
Marco, what are you drinking?
Just an orange juice, please.
Better make that a double.
Back.
First day.
You're wasting your time. She's getting married tomorrow, isn't that right, Emma?
I came back to fresh for you.
Were you too late?
To the airport.
Marco!
Please, can you help me?
What is the matter? You bought him here. You lost him.
I've been robbed. I've lost all my money.
I am not putting my job on the line for either of you. Get in the frigging car.
You again. Marco, your day of crewing is well and truly over.
On the tannoy, you're on the 105.
Yeah, all right, keep your hair on.
It's boarding.
Oh!
Now, Casey!
You bitch! Fucking hell! Oh, bastards! Oh, yeah.
Hi, morning, sir.
Good morning. Straight down the back, madam.
Thank you.
23C in the middle.
Oh, my God.
What?
Michael Webb.
He owns the Bar X train. He's number 57 on the rich list.
This way, please, madam.
I'd like to take a seat there. That's 37A, window seat halfway back. If you're thinking of working during the flights, Mr. Webb, I could see about getting you an aisle seat. It would give you a bit more room.
Well, that's very considerate of you. Casey.
Don't mention it. Taking care of you will be my pleasure. What's he doing on Third World Air? Even millionaires like bargains.
I thought the girl you booked was called Tracy.
Tracy, Casey. Guess I misheard.
But he isn't the other girl. She's a lot better looking.
By the time I'm through with 4 hours of lawyers' meetings, I don't care. As long as it's available, I've got a pulse.
Your cabin crew will now give you a short demonstration of the safety procedures aboard our aircraft today. In the event of landing on water, remove the life jacket from its container and pull it over your head. Pass the tapes around your waist and tie them securely in a double bow at the side. There is a whistle here for attracting attention. Do not inflate your jacket anywhere outside the aircraft.
Sparkling mineral water, ice and lemon. Is there anything else I can get for you?
Do you take this good care of all your passengers, Casey?
Well, we aim to make your flight as pleasant as possible.
I can't wait to find out how pleasant you're going to make my evening.
You asked me out. You just asked me out.
Blimey. What did you do? Slip a steroid in his mineral water?
Well, I suppose a man like him doesn't hang about. If he wants something, he just goes for it.
Date of my entire life, and my leg is like four hamburgers.
That drinks trolley is not going to wheel itself down the aisles, ladies. Thank you.
Did you pack everything you need?
Mum, you don't have to drive me here every day. I can't get the train.
Don't be daft, love.
Where is it today? Paris? Rome?
Amsterdam first. I'm late for my briefing. Mum, if I don't run, I'm going to miss my flight.
And all the boats that have left the shore, a thousand people nevermore. And if the sun broke through their eyes, we could sense their deep surprise. And I guess we'll assume that we're playing different tunes. I'm
They always say to live, you're such a shame. We all feel the pain, a stupid game. You're such a shame. There is no game.
Marco? Marco Bailey? Marco? What are you doing here? Your hearing's not till 3. And what's with the luggage? I mean, even if they do reinstate you, you won't be going anywhere today. I'll see you outside briefing room 10 at 1:15, okay?
Okay.
Listen, Marco, I know me and Casey are partly to blame for what happened in Spain. We shouldn't have whisked you off to Alicante like that. If it's between one of us losing a job or all three, then... Well, Casey's got a mortgage.
It's okay. I won't drop you in it.
See you later.
Hi, sir. Thank you for flying, sir. I'm Adam.
Are you girls still staying at the Valdezero?
Yeah, that's right. Have you flown with us before?
Yeah, once or twice. Listen, I got a business meeting and it's going to be running late, so why don't I send my limo round to your hotel around 9:30 and I'll bring you to my yacht. Is that okay for you?
That's fine.
Yeah. I really look forward to that.
Me too.
Ugh, smarmy git.
You're just jealous.
Mum? No, I'm still in Amsterdam. Because it's a tri-band phone, it takes calls anyway. Look, my flight's being called. I'm gonna have to go. No, I don't have time for the duty-free shop, sorry. Look, I've really got to go. I love you too. Bye.
You stupid bloody idiot! I might have known it would have been you. Well, don't just stand there gawping. Get me a tissue or something. What are you doing here anyway? Thought you'd been sacked days ago.
It's my disciplinary hearing today.
Oh, good. So we're very fortunate we might not have to see each other again. Well, Marco, it's been, memorable.
I'm sorry I'm late. They're ready for you now.
Oh, what happened?
Oh, Marco! Wait! Oh, this is useless. We haven't enough time. Surely you've got something in here.
No! My parents never wanted me to take this job. I couldn't tell them I'd screwed up my very first day.
Commando, baby.
Less to take off when you finally get down to it.
I won't be getting down to it. First rule of relationships, don't give it up on the first date.
Oh, come on. You know passengers don't come back for seconds.
This one will, if I play my cards right. That's where you come in, by the way. Bang on midnight, just as things are getting steamy. And you just give me a ring. Just make up some emergency. I rush, he's left panting for more.
Ooh, not if your knickers are showing through the arse of your dress, he won't.
All right, then. Satisfied?
OK, how much? €300?
That will be €3,250. How would you like to pay?
Thank you.
You can't use your fresh credit card.
Shut up. I'm over the limit on all of mine. Lovely. Thanks very much. I've told you, Lee, I'll just take it back in the morning.
Yeah, if that snotty bitch refuses, you're stuffed. The airline will be taken out of your wages for a year, and that's if they don't sack you.
Oh, come on, Lee. I might never again in my whole life get a shot at a man like Michael Webb. I've got to go for it.
If he likes you half as much as you want him to, it should be for your personality, not $3,000 worth of dress.
Get real. Men like him don't go out with girls for their personalities. You've got to look class if you want to pull class.
Class? The guy has a few bars and some dirty magazines.
Do you realise how much it costs me to maintain myself to attract a rich guy? I am so tired of being skintly, Anne.
Yeah, we're all skint case. Kind of goes with the territory.
Good afternoon, Marco. I'm Kevin McMillan, head of personnel here at Fresh. You know Ray Lewis, your team leader?
Please, take a seat.
I understood you were bringing a union representative with you.
Yes, he's just on his way.
Can we kiss you on the lips? Can we do it like this, 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 this?
Sorry I'm late.
Right, let's get started. James Motherbur, your CSD on the Valencia flight, has filed a report. So has Janice Steele, the Fresh employee who found you naked in the pool of the Hotel Grand Player last week.
Congratulations, Marco. You appear to have broken the record for the world's shortest career as a flight attendant.
He left his luggage unattended in the secure area.
He was wrongly advised about security procedures.
He was late for his first flight.
Actually, he was half an hour early. He was, in fact, directed to the wrong room.
He didn't think to check. And if that wasn't enough, instead of going to his hotel and getting some rest after his first flight, he embarked on a 240-mile round trip to Alicante.
Where are we going?
Alicante.
Alicante?
Whose crazy idea was that?
It was mine. I've never been to Spain before, and I wanted them to show me the sights.
That's not strictly true. It was our idea. That is, Casey, Gregory and myself. One of our friends was getting married the next day, and we wanted to spend some time at our hen party. Didn't want to leave Marco alone, because it was his first day, so we insisted he come with us.
Which shows poor judgment on your part as well. But Marco is an adult. He's a big boy. He could have refused to go. He certainly didn't need to get drunk. So drunk that he was found in a public place wearing nothing but a lilo.
You couldn't wear anything underneath it anyway. It's borderline.
Yes, so long as he doesn't get to see the horror movie that lies beneath.
Take these.
I do hope they're classy enough for you. Oh, Lee, they're lovely. Thank you.
Just don't lose them.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to do any rolling around, am I?
Do you know what?
What?
You look absolutely gorgeous. I do hope he's worth it.
I've got such a good feeling about tonight.
Oh, God, now, please remember to ring me bang on midnight so I can make my excuses and do a runner.
Sure.
What do you think?
I can hold my breath. Hey, there's plenty of other jobs out there. And what's so special about this one? The pay's lousy. You spend all day on your feet being polite to a bunch of arseholes. You ready for us yet?
Won't keep you much longer. I wanted this job so much. Just to see the world. Live a bit. Prove I could do a day's work someone other than my father would actually pay me for. Thanks for trying, anyway.
Wait here. It's been a long time, Kevin. So how's married life?
What do you want?
He's a good kid. And I think you've been very hard on him. Very, very hard. So, what's it gonna take to get him off?
Yeah, email Dougie the drafts. Any amendments we'll send back. And you can courier the signature copies Friday. Yeah, I gotta go, George. I've got company.
Oh, look at you. You look terrific.
Thank you.
Come on, come up here. Look, you get the greatest...
Oh!
Jesus, you all right?
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
Sorry.
Wow. You
came dressed for action. Or should I say undressed?
Sorry,
You don't apologise. I like people who get straight to business. But,
let's eat first, yeah?
Enrique, get up here.
And I've had a word with schedules. You're rostered back on as of 7 tomorrow morning.
Thank you. Thank you.
It goes without saying that one more infringement...
There won't be.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you, Mr. McMillan. You won't regret it. Oh, and do give my best to the lovely Mrs. McMillan.
What happened? One minute they said to hang Joran Quarterman, and the next...
Knows. So, now that you're staying, why do you come back with me and check out the flat?
I'm not sure.
Oh, come on! You said you wanted to get away from your parents. Now's your chance. Welcome to our humble abode.
All right, mate, I didn't think I'd see you again.
And John. Right, let's give you the guided tour. This is the kitchen. Anything in this fridge with a label on it belongs to Casey. Touch it and you will surely die. Everything else is past its sell-by date, so it'll probably kill you anyway. Come on, let's go.
One, two, three!
And this is Emma's old room. Leanne's away. Why don't you keep down here for tonight, you know, just to get a feel of the place, and then we can sort out the room arrangements when Casey gets back.
Oh, I'm not sure. I should really let my mum know. OK.
Excellent. I'll, just let you settle in.
Must be amazing, living like this.
Well, the crew are the only ones who get to live here. I come down, I don't know, maybe once a month. You know, you think you're doing it for the lifestyle, but the truth is... you have to work so damned hard, you know, keeping it all together, that you don't get a chance to enjoy it. You know, you get to see your family and friends, I don't even know who your friends are, most of the time.
It's easy to forget that somebody like you has problems.
You know, I expected you to be much more hard-boiled, Casey, you know, doing the kind of job you do.
People knock at my job But the way I see it is I'm providing service.
Hmm.
And I get to travel and see lots of places, meet lots of people. I love it. I don't think I can manage that.
Of course you can. Something tells me you're a girl with a big appetite. Sure you're not going to join me in a brandy?
Yes, thanks, no.
All right. In that case, Enrique, you can go.
Okay.
Casey's going to be looking after me for the rest of the evening.
Please, Michael, no!
What?
I'm sorry. I'm expecting a call.
What, now?
Yeah.
Listen, Casey. You know, I've had a really tiring day, and this is not what I signed up for.
It's not that I don't want to. Oh, I do. It's just too soon.
It's too soon. I don't get it.
I'm sorry, mate. Shh. Didn't realise you were in here. On the Geneva flight at 8.
I think Emma's bed's free.
Ta.
Night then. Night.
What's up, mate?
There you go.
Practicing tonight.
Okay.
You just said that you're like a man.
Pardon?
Just then. You said it. But you only had to ask. Come on, move over.
No, you don't understand.
I'm fine. I'm just coming for a cuddle. It'll be okay.
Look, no, I was just having a dream.
Oh, come on, look. I'm just going to have a little lie down.
Will, please, just stop.
Oh, my God. What the hell is he doing in my bed?
I'm sorry, it's just, you're very attractive. You like me, don't you?
Thank you.
really sorry. It's my fault. I said everyone could crash. All right, we just didn't expect you back from your honeymoon so soon. Don't go, mate. You can stay in my room if you want.
It's okay. I'm freshening up at the centre. Flying in a few hours.
Oh, I'm really sorry, mate. It's nice meeting you anyway.
Better get off.
Don't think he was too chuffed about being woken up.
So come you back so soon?
Em's mum phoned. Told us the new flat's fallen through.
Oh, bastard.
Yeah, then the flight back got delayed. Anyway, better let you get some sleep.
Yeah.
I better get going too.
Oh, don't be so daft. You can sleep on the couch. I promise I won't try and touch you.
Lee, I'm gonna have to call you back. Okay. Where is Michael? Mr. Webb?
Mr. Webb is gone.
What?
He asked me to give you this.
Okay, you can go now. Flush down that loo.
Do you think I care about the money?
Well, you're gonna have to care, Casey. You've got a 3,000 euro dress that they're never gonna take back.
Will you tell me the truth, please, Leanne? Do I look like a prostitute?
Tell me the name of the boat.
The, Oh, I don't know.
Well, think.
The Santa... Rose, I don't know, Leanne,
KC, shuttle's here.
Get dressed, quick. Take my bag and get on the bus.
Where are you going?
To make sure you don't get taken for a mug twice over. Who did he have to do to get him off, Will?
I beg your pardon.
Oh. Don't play the innocent with me. He's got all the hallmarks of one of your bits of fresh meat. Young, pretty, gormless. Well, this time, you really have let your dick do the thinking. He's no more capable of being a flight attendant than you are of captaining the England rugby team. They won't last two sectors.
You want to bet?
Oh, grow up. People's lives are in our hands. I have no idea what cretin saw fit to give you your job back, or why. But in exactly 2.5 minutes' time, 158 people will board this aircraft. We have 3 wheelchairs, 2 babies, 2 unaccompanied minors, and a stag party. It will be your job to greet, seat, feed, and water them for the next 2.5 hours. Hello? Screw up once, and I'll have your genitals on the plate.
OK, I'll take that for you. Marco, stow this for me, please. Thank you. No, not in there. In here, please. Sir, can I just take that jacket for you? Marco, quickly. All right, gents, let's have you in your seat. Come on, let's have the pig well under the seat.
And your seatbelt fastened. Thank you very much. Will, no, we can't move in now. We've got to wait till everybody else has been seated. Sorry, sir, we will move you as soon as possible. Thanks for bearing with us. Thank you. Sir, I need to actually store this in an overhead locker. Marco, in an overhead locker, thank you. Madam, if you could just keep your seatbelt fastened. Yeah, and keep that bag well under the seat, thank you. Yeah, just keep that belt fastened, can you? Thank
you. Hey, there's a £200 bottle of wine in there.
Marco, I'll deal with this. If I can just have you back in the seat, please, sir. I will check the bag. If the bottle has been broken, it will be covered on your insurance. Thank you very much, thank you. Marco, we've got 2 minutes to get that lot sat down and the door shut, or else we'll lose our slot. Do you hear me?
We'll be cruising at an altitude of 35,000 feet today. Most of the flights should be quite smooth, but there is a chance of some turbulence later on.
It's quite likely that we'll be switching the seatbelt signs off during the first part of the flight, but if you are sitting down at the time,
I would urge you to keep your seatbelts fastened, just as an extra precaution.
Thank you.
Last night. Mm-hmm. Casey, with Mr. Webb? She left her handbag.
Sorry, you cannot come here. This is a private booth.
Oh, well, she left it in the bedroom. Are they from here? Bedroom?
No.
Yes?
Get out from this booth.
You know what? I really, really need the loo.
No hot drinks during turbulence.
So sorry.
I'm free.
Going down first floor, ladies' lingerie, fashion. Very sorry, sir. Quick smile, for God's sake, will you? Quick seat pocket, get a bag. There you go, sir. I'll get you another drink.
Marco, go and clean yourself up and then just sit down, will you? Are you all right? I'm gonna torch the boat.
With the lemon juice?
Okay, okay. Listen, I'm sure there's something we can do to break this.
Welcome to Rome, where the local time is 11:20 a.m. We know you have a choice today, so on behalf of Captain Weatherall and his crew, we thank you for choosing fresh. We hope to see you all on board again very soon. Thank you.
Marco!
No!
Do you understand the instruction, doors to manual?
Yes.
Then why didn't you do it? If it hadn't have been for Will's quick thinking, you'd have set off the emergency chute. Have you got any idea of the consequences? £28,000 just to repack it. To say nothing of stranding us all here for half a day. Oh, and cocking up the entire airline schedule.
Look, Janice, it didn't happen. Let's just give the kid a break, yeah?
Right, we have got exactly 12 and a half minutes to get this rubbish tip sorted out before the next lot get on. I suggest you start with the loos.
You okay?
Yeah, she's right. I'm not up to it. I'm going to give him a notice at the end of the day.
You think about me now, sweetheart? Not after all I've been through for you. Here. Take this.
What is it?
It'll calm your nerves. I use them all the time.
I don't take drugs.
Oh, come on, it's herbal. You know, one of those homeopathic things. Trust me.
Thank you.
Can you see if the flight deck needs drinks?
Yeah, in a minute. I can't do everything.
What's the matter with her?
Oh, a tummy bug, I think. Yeah, she had it all last night.
So how come at breakfast I saw her sneaking into the lift in last night's party clothes?
Okay. She had a row with a boyfriend.
We've all got personal problems. We don't bring them to work. Don't not be lied to, Leanne, especially not by you.
Don't worry about the flight deck. I'll do it.
A man looks at me and he doesn't see a girlfriend. He doesn't even see a date. He just sees trash.
That is not true. Casey?
It's amazing how you girls can go all night and work all day.
Get your hand off my arse before I break your arm.
Don't be like that. Listen, I'm down this way again next week. And I really fancy girls like you, if you know what I mean. Dark meat. Can I call you direct or should I go through the agency?
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you not? No offence, I just thought, what will your friend be?
Being what?
You know, on the game.
My friend is not on the game.
Well, tell that to my friend, because he booked her. And from what I gather, he got his money's worth last night.
Are you still doing that? They're boarding any minute. Marco, did you hear me?
Totally. Be with you straight away, Janice.
Feeling?
Fine, thank you. Is that the lot?
Yeah, so close the door and let's get going.
I told you to get there.
Jules, have you got any eye drops?
Yeah, sure.
Who's it for? Bastard in 12C. With any luck, he will have the shits all the way across France. Sparkling mineral water, 2 ice cubes, and a slice of lemon.
I'll take that, sir. Lipstick on the glass. I'll get you a new one.
KC, for eye drops? Don't risk the sack. Not for him.
You're called?
Deal with this, will you, Dyke? Have a drink. Okay, brilliant.
Somebody just handed me this. They said they picked it up by mistake in the terminal.
Okay, drop down last property for us, will you, Jose? Gracias.
Adios.
Seen before.
Did I not pay you enough or something?
Sit down.
Hey!
Why?
Come again.
Why did you think I was a prostitute?
Well, I booked you. This is usually a good sign.
I don't know who you thought you booked, but it certainly wasn't me.
You know, the agency told us. Tracy.
It's Tracy Rogers.
You're not, Yeah, listen. I'm sorry.
If you hadn't thought I was a hooker, last night, would it have happened?
You know, you're a really nice girl.
Answer me. Would it have happened? Would you have asked me out?
No. Because what you offer
frankly. I can buy.
Sorry, sir.
I'm so sorry.
Doesn't matter. I'm getting used to it. Yeah, you sit down here and I'll get you some water. Should I take those for you?
Go and clean yourself up. There's a spare waistcoat in the crew locker. Then take a rest. Start the descent in 10.
That's okay. I can manage.
Marco, are you okay?
Couldn't be better. Janice, look. Isn't that beautiful? Doesn't a moment like this make the whole job worthwhile?
Yes, it does. Now go and clean yourself up. You didn't say, please hang up my jacket, sir. You simply said, deal with this. I assumed it was lost property.
You did this deliberately, you bitch.
So please don't use that language with my team.
Listen to me, you dozy fag. See, we got business in London, and we don't have time for you to fly my jacket out from Spain.
Well, I'm afraid without a passport, immigration won't let you through. Not till they've done security checks. Now, if you'd like to follow our ground staff, they'll show you where you can wait.
You were a lousy lay, my darling, and next time, you'd have to pay me.
You do know you're going to have to tell someone in wages that you put that address on the car.
Tracy Rogers, can I have a word?
KC.
A private word.
I'll wait here.
What's this about?
Does the name Michael Ware ring any bells?
No, I've never heard of him.
Well, that's funny, because he seems to have heard of you. In fact, he was so convinced I was you, he wanted to pay me a little money just to sleep with him.
You should be flattered.
Because he thought I was a whore.
Listen, I don't think I've got anything left to say to you, but I think twice before shooting off your mouth.
Oh, really? And why is that?
If you didn't go around acting like a whore, you wouldn't be taken for one.
Kate, some bloke seriously give you €2,000 for a shack.
Get out, Jason.
Do you think this agency would take on the bloke?
I said, get out.
Why doesn't a girl like me get to go out with a man like Michael Webb? For real, I mean.
You don't want to go out with a guy like him. He's scum.
Yes, I do. I want to eat pancakes flambéed by my own chef off matching designer plates. Drink champagne on my own yacht watching the sunset. There's women that have got that, Lee. I mean, why not me? I spent 2,000 quid on a designer dress and he still mistook me for a cheap hooker.
But Casey, you are only interested in men with money. Doesn't that turn sex into a business deal too? I mean, babes, you're gonna sleep with him anyway. At least this way, you got a shitload of cash for it.
You don't understand.
Those pills.
Amazing, aren't they?
Can I get them in Boots or do we need to go to a health food place? What's funny?
No, Marco, you can't buy them in shops. Well, the way things are probably going, you're doing well. It was an E.
You gave me a Class A drug.
Yeah, but it helped you do the job, didn't it?
What if I had a reaction to it? What if I died in the middle of a flight?
Look, everybody takes something from time to time. Ease, Prozac, beta blockers. It helps them cope with the stress.
I want to do this job through my own abilities, not because I'm stuffed full of mind-altering chemicals.
Look, you weren't complaining you thought the drugs were legal, were you?
We're just going home now.
Thanks for the news bulletin. Marco, it was, a very difficult day today. I didn't think you'd cope. I was wrong.
No, she wasn't such a frigid ice queen. I'd say she's got a soft spot for you. Right, let's get you home. Casey will be there. We can sort this room out. Hello, Marco.
Must be the drugs.
Yeah.
I'd advise you to sit down immediately.
You can't tell me what to do.
What are you doing? Get off!
You want to have sex with us?
Excuse me?
Hotel rooms are boring. They're for sleeping.
Marco Bailey and Jason Murdoch.
Jackie, look, no.
What are you doing here?
I told you I was going to make you pay, didn't I?
After a decade apart, can the tide of time pull you back together?
Oh, my God. It doesn't feel like 10 years. It feels like 10 minutes.
Really gone very, very well.
We're going to have a riot, aren't we? Yeah.
Is it love? Back to the beach next on Sky One. And just time to remind you, the all-new season of Dream Team kicks off this Sky One Sunday at 8.